You see, I'm being very honest, and we always were honest. Yes, there was a difference of opinion within the party. And there was a strong difference of opinion, which eventually went in our party structure to the highest decision-making authority, which is the party Congress, where there was a vote taken. And then by majority, it was decided that yes, his not accepting was correct.
CPM leader Sitaram Yechuri explaining what Jyoti Basu later called the historic blunder of the party. His party's decision not to make him prime minister in the coalition government in 1996 will perhaps ensure that history remembers Jyoti Basu as the best prime minister India never had. In many ways, the life of the longest serving chief minister of India mirrors the communist movement in the country. As chief minister of Bengal, Jyoti Basu presided over historic land reforms that have ensured a three-decade unbroken rule for his party in that state, but also massive erosion of capital and talent from Bengal. He was personally impeccably refined and honest, but tolerated mass-scale cadre raj that killed growth and industrialization, brought about crippling labor stagnation and erosion of work culture, politicized the colleges and removed English as the primary language in state-run schools, which ensured that millions of children could not compete. Basu, the London-educated barrister at the Middle Temple, took over a state which was economically only second to Maharashtra. By the time the last of the Bhadralok or gentleman chief ministers left in 2000, Bengal had become the synonym of industrial malaise, labour unrest and sloth. As head of a state which had the subcontinent's first modern university in 1857, Basu presided over the politicisation of colleges, using them as cadre base and killing innovation and entrepreneurship. His followers point out that Jyoti Basu in many cases actually tried to bring capital into the state. In 1985, in spite of critics in the CPM, Basu pushed through a joint venture with the RPG Group to start Holdia Petrochemicals. But he also allowed Bengal's Amul, the Horinghatta dairy, which at one point supplied 30,000 litres of milk, to fall to ruin. Whatever his intention, it is undeniable that under Jyoti Basu, Bengal failed to create an environment for industry or growth.
But remember, what Buddhadev Bhattacharya is saying is no different from what Jyoti Basu said for 17 years earlier. But the corporate world and investment was coming at this point of time because that qualitative change had taken place, where Bengal became the fastest growing rural market in the country. So you had avenues for profit. So naturally capital comes. It doesn't come because of Buddhadev or me or you. I mean, it comes when it sees profits.
But even in his autumn, the patriarch remained agile and astute, far above most of his other party colleagues. He is said to have advised caution as the state battled villagers in Shingur and Nondigram, and opposed the party's decision to withdraw from the first Manmohan Singh government on the nuclear deal issue. The communists' worst showing in the 2008 polls left him heartbroken. In a sense, Basu is the perfect metaphor for the communist movement in India, defeated much more by its own dogma than its detractors. Hindulsan Gupta, Bloomberg UTV, New Delhi.